We're under caution at Watkins Glen. A terrible crash for Denny Hamlin. That is in turn one at the end of the front straightaway.
This looks a lot like a brake failure. Saw no skid marks going down in there. This is a tire barrier. You can see there's a guardrail there.
You see Denny inside the car. And the safety workers there attending to him.
Very high speed getting into turn one. We're counting on that brake pedal to be there. It's not.
Yeah. And there's just nothing you can do. There's no way. You can't turn the car. You can't turn it off. You can't do anything that's really going to slow the car down enough at that point in time.
Kind of similar to what Brad Keselowski's car looked like from Road Atlanta when he had that accident.
Yeah. And Denny climbing from the car.
Man. Testament to the safety of these vehicles and the...
He's out.
This young man works hard in the gym on his physical conditioning, and I think that has a lot to do with it, too.
Two words here. Watch this.
Yeah, it looks like it's...
It's got some brakes.
The front brakes are... The left front's locked up.
It's almost like the throttle hung.
Man, that could have been. It could have been the throttle hung pushing the front tire.
Man, look at how much it moved that guardrail, even through the tire barrier.
You can see the smoke from the front tires, like he's trying to get this car stopped, and maybe the throttle is hung partially.
Man.
Yeah, those rear tires are still going hard.
Yeah. Oh. Crash there for Denny Hamlin. Fortunately, he climbed from the car and did walk away. And naturally, it brings up the images of Jimmy Johnson's terrible crash there in that Nationwide Series race several years back when he lost his brakes over the top of the gravel trap.
Man, you can see the track is configured different because it had gravel then, had a styrofoam wall. Man, that is just a hard, hard lick. It's short neck car of about 4 feet.
Watkins Glen International, and what has been a very difficult weekend for Denny Hamlin. This was in qualifying.
Out of turn five. Lost track. That said, he had a very fast race car.
And just moments ago. A brutal hit in turn number one. Denny climbing from the car. And going and back and looking at some of this, watch the shape of the guardrail after the hit and watch where he hit and what's behind the guardrail.
Well, one of the posts there is going to be, you see the concrete is there holding that fence. He could have hit in between there and possibly softened that blow just a little bit. But I can assure you, folks, there is not a worse feeling as a driver when that throttle hangs.
While we watch this action, Denny Hamlin has been released from the care center. Dave?
He walked under his own power, Alan. Denny, how are you feeling?
I feel, you know, better than I thought I would. I mean, it felt like it was in slow motion for me, but can't say enough for all the safety precautions NASCAR takes. And obviously the wall helped a lot. Getting that dampered the hit a little bit, but really encourage all these drivers to go seven-point safety belts. I had those, and it just it really softened the blow quite a bit. A lot of these guys run 5-point, and it's just not enough. So that's a testament to all the safety stuff we have.
We saw the rear wheels sprinting, the front wheels locked up. Do you think the throttle hung?
No, throttle didn't hang. Something blew out in the left front, and when it did, it must have cut a brake line, so I had no brakes, and so I was trying to do everything I could to weave or anything I could to get the speed out of the car, and just there's nothing you can do. Front tire's locked up and can't steer, but it's a shame. Our FedEx Ground Toyota was really good all day, and just we're going to be right there about fourth or fifth in line on this restart, but wasn't meant to be today.
He drove from 42nd to 12th, and his day ended with that, Alan. Glad he's okay.